So aside from the Goodwill stuff, dining room done, all the stuff we want to keep here will stay here. Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. I'm here in the sitting area of my bedroom and I'm filming the intro of this video because I thought I filmed it. I must have thought I pressed record and I just started speaking, assumed it recorded because now I can't find it. So anyway, this is the intro for this video footage of me and my daughter and some friends helping to start the decluttering process because we are planning to sell my parents' house. So this is the dining room and living room, and we put all the Goodwill stuff here, and we're gonna get a truck to bring this out. The laundry room, we're leaving this to go with the house. I am taking this freezer and I'll be doing a video sometime of it. Need to clean that out. I mean, this is a great house and lots of storage space. So this whole room is finished. We got up here, all the cabinets are now empty. So what we're doing is we're going room by room, cabinet by cabinet, drawer, under the sink, one by one, every shelf, every hanger, things on the floor, behind the door, making sure there's not stuff there. And then we're putting it into piles. So you saw the Goodwill pile, this pile that we're bringing home. These are hazardous materials, so they have to be disposed of properly. So I gotta check out when the city does that. This is a pile for my brother. This is a pile for the ones who are helping me right now. And then over here is the trash and recycling. So luckily the neighbor will be the one taking care of that when it's trash day. And then all the other junks, this is junk trash that I will be getting a junk removal company to take care of this. And you know, this twin mattress, that was my brother's when we were growing up. So that's like, what, 40, 45 years old. As far as the garage, I'll have to come back another time. We're not gonna finish. We're already 2 hours in. We're getting a lot done. We're pretty fast, there's four of us. But this will be a whole separate thing. My brother still has to go through these things, if there are any tools that he wants. And then the neighbor does want to get some of the stuff here. He and my dad used to do projects together. So he said, like, even up here, that shelving, they did that together. And then they did it at his house. Okay, then here, this closet, all done. So that is my suggestion. It's like you start at one end of the house and then you just clear out each room versus each of you taking on a different space. We started with this room because it's at the end of the house, okay? And we're leaving some of the major furniture. If the people who buy it want it, then they can take it. But when they buy it and they don't want it, I'm gonna come back here and have these sold or disposed, whatever. Okay, closet's all done. Check behind the door, on the floor. Check under the bed, that was a good idea by my daughter. So we started here in this room, went to the bathroom. So first room done, bathroom done, closet done, laundry room done, including that over there. Then we came in here, so aside from the Goodwill stuff, dining room done, all the stuff we want to keep here will stay here. All the major furniture for the living room will stay here. Okay, then this, the kitchen, I'm gonna do that a whole nother time because the kitchen's usually a big project. So we go over here, this is the den. That's a room there, a bathroom, lots to do there. So we went to this room next, so it's almost done. And then I will show you more when we get more stuff done. Okay, so you can see here, just check the closet, check the floor, done. So check, so then we'll go to like example the desk and just make sure the drawers are empty. Okay, and I'm gonna leave this desk here and the bed just so the buyer can see kind of the space. And I will have the cleaners, the handyman will come after we clear out everything. Then I'll have the cleaners and then I'll have window cleaners. You know, it's just a lot of cleaning up and touch up to do. All right, you can see that this room is done and it's not gonna be the prettiest matching decor stuff. In fact, the realtor said we don't even have to have anything inside. So what we're doing is we're just gonna go ahead and leave the furniture inside just so that they get an idea of what it looks like. And as I said earlier, the handyman is gonna take care of stuff like that on the wall, the baseboards, and then the cleaners will come and clean up everything. This is a TV stand. I'll put this in the Goodwill pile, but check out how, oh, I can't do that with one hand, but let me show you the Goodwill pile right now. Okay, we're going here and we're not even done with the family room yet, but this is humongous. Lots of Goodwill, so yeah, we're just gonna make it happen. Here is an update of the den. We pretty much took everything out, took down the Christmas tree. Never thought that was gonna happen. That's been up for years. We're gonna leave this picture here, and then when the junk removal people come, I'm going to have them bring that out and we'll just leave this space open. That's what the bookshelf looks like. So we kept all of the National Geographic collection up here. We're probably gonna take it home. My husband is really kind of liking it, me too. We've obviously now have to let go of space in our house in order to put this in. And so, but we wanted to keep it here to stage it a little bit to show them how much this bookshelf can house. And let's just go through the cabinets. This is for actually the keyboard, and then the printer down here also slides, or if you have, you know, like that computer box, the hard drive or the tower. Okay, and then these are pretty much used also. Oh, I wonder if that, so yeah, so this slides in like this, but if I think these just didn't have shelves, you have to put your own shelves. A little TV would fit in here, and then, you know, if you have other stuff you want to put inside there, like your gaming console. So when the kids and the cousins were growing up, this was their room. So they had the computer, they had the TV, the game console. This had a couch here. So lots of memories in this house, and that is empty too. So all of these cabinets, I mean, everything was filled. So we did a lot of work. We're kind of slowing down right now, kind of at the point where it's diminishing returns as far as our energy. So we're pretty much packing up. They're going through my mom's room right now just to see if there's, you know, more, looking for the valuables, but we'll come back for that. So here is the bathroom that is shared by that room that I've shown you, and then this room that I will show you in a little bit. It's a double sink, and the toilet is back here, which is nice, you know, some privacy. That's the side of the house, and then here is the bathtub, if you can see that. And then, oh, I didn't check this one. Okay, yeah, so you even have two medicine cabinets here. It's, I mean, it's a great, it's, I forgot how many square feet. I'll look that up and I'll share it sometime in maybe the next video, because there has to be a part two here because we're not going to be done. And yeah, the cabinets are all done. I'm just going to leave that one toilet paper here because, like I said, we will be coming back finishing up the kitchen, the pantry, my mom's room and closet and bathroom. And you see that's empty, and the family room and kitchen nook. And then over here, okay, so you have this other room here, which is pretty large, and it's got a nice ceiling height. And this is actually to the backyard. Let me show you. So that's the pool. I'll show you that later. And we also have to do the back patio and the area over there, the garage. There's still a lot more to do. But this is a great size room. I've always liked this room. This room tends to be the warmer room because it's over this side of the house. There are two air conditionings for this house. So we're leaving this up there. So it kind of shows you where the bed would go. Okay. And this is a humongous closet. Look at that. Can you see that? It doesn't really translate in the video, but okay, look at this. See, that's at least, I think that's 16 inches, maybe 18. So I'm totally standing in here. So my back is against the wall. Look, I mean, this is how much space. So this is the regular size closet would come out to here, right? I mean, but it's got all this space still. So we did this a couple months back when my brother and my sister were here, had some help, my sister-in-law, and we had my mom's caregiver was helping us too. Okay, so that's trash, so I'll be bringing that out. All right, friends, well, I hope you enjoyed this very impromptu, casual tour of me and my daughter, our two friends, now my husband is helping, decluttering my parents' house, getting it ready to be sold. My mom is living near me now, and yeah, it's a long process. I was expecting to do the whole house in 5 hours. It's been 4.5, and it's probably gonna be another, at least, I'm thinking another 2 times of that, so maybe another 8-10 hours. But I hope you enjoyed this. I look like a hot mess, but when, if you've gone through this process of going through your parents' home, that they've lived here for, I think, 15 years, maybe 16, and they like to keep stuff. Let me know if you've gone through that process, what is maybe a tip that you have, and share it with the rest of our community here. And I'll see you in the next video. Click this one here if you want to see more organizing videos, and take care. Bye.